and welcome to a Beth Money Collection sizing and review video with me, your girl T. And today we're going to be reviewing the Naked Collection. All right, this video is already super long because there's so much to talk about. So I'm going to breeze through the housekeeping stuff as quickly as I can so we can get into the actual pieces. So right off the bat, this collection launches on June 24th at 1 p.m. Central. You can shop it at buffbunny.com/Teresa, where if you use code Teresa, you can save 10% off your entire order, and you're eligible to enter my monthly support code giveaway, where I select three random winners to get a $100 Buff Bunny Collection gift card. This collection is so beautiful, and it's all neutrals, which I know you either love neutrals or you hate neutrals, and I used to be a not neutral lover, but they've grown on me. They have so grown on me, and I'm so happy to see this collection come to life. And these pieces are just so pretty, and I'm excited to share them with you. Sizing wise, I am kind of in between a large and an extra large right now. Sorry, Mila wants his cameo. Between a large and an extra large right now. So my sizing is kind of all over the place depending on the piece. So make sure that you pay attention to like the pieces that you're interested in, so you know whether to size upside down, they run small, run big, or whatever. For the most part, I tend to be large bras, large and extra large leggings, and extra large shorts. I wear a 36 double D bra. And I'm 5'2", I have a 34 inch waist and 49 inch hips, and yeah. Okay, if I missed any other important information, I will make sure to put it in the description box. Make sure that you also follow me on Instagram because I will be doing a giveaway, and that's honestly where you're gonna get the latest, like most up-to-date information regarding this launch. Little mini disclaimer, I have been recording this video over the course of 3 days, and the first day I had some technical difficulties, so some parts of this video are going to be like out of focus or glitchy, and I'm so sorry about that, but I don't have the time to re-record every little piece that's messed up, so just bear with me. Most of it is good, it's just there's some parts where it's, like I said, out of focus or whatever, and I hope that you will forgive me for that. And since I recorded over 3 days, my lighting is different. Like right now it's nighttime, but some of these were recorded broad daylight. I try to record most of the actual like pieces during daylight hours so we get the best lighting, and then most of like my talking parts during night, because it doesn't really matter, I could just use a ring light. But just full disclosure, I wanted to make sure that you knew that before you get into my comments and start hating on it. All right, without further ado, let's get into it. Okay, this is the ribbed seamless sports bra. It is one shoulder bra. It's the ribbing material. And okay, so if you're in between sizes with this one, I'm gonna recommend that you size up. So this material, like itself, like this part right here, is pretty breathable, it's pretty stretchy. My thing is that these ribbed pieces, like all of the seams are tight. Like this right here is tight. This is tight, but not as tight. It's really these thin ones right here. So I'm gonna get closer, you can see. So it's like these thin ones right here. These are tight. And then this bottom one, which is like a little bit wider, it's still like tight, but it's not like super tight. But that being said, I do have a large, and it feels borderline tight. Like, I'm okay with it. Like, I think that I can wear it to the gym and I'll be fine. I can wear it on a day out and be fine. I'm kind of hoping that the more I wear it, the more it'll stretch out and it'll be fine. But like, if you're definitely between sizes, which I kind of am at the moment, it's just, I think I could benefit from going a size up. The other thing is like, because it is tight, it tends to roll. See, it tends to roll on me because it's tight. Like, it just wants to roll. So I think like going up a size, if I'm in between sizes, would help prevent that. If you're not between sizes but you don't like feeling compressed, you don't like feeling like tight seams, then I totally would recommend just sizing up. That being said, I really love the look of this bra. I think it's like so girly, it's so cute. I don't think we've had a one shoulder bra in a minute. I know we had some with Frozen, and we had some with Let's Get Toned. I think that's it. I could be having a brain fart moment, but I know I haven't gotten a one shoulder bra from Buff Bunny in a hot minute. So yeah, I'm excited to see these coming in. The good thing about this being a little bit tighter is that I don't have to worry about this falling down. Like, it doesn't slip, it stays nice and tight, which is what they were, like, I guess, going for with these pieces. They're supposed to, like, lock you in and keep everything together. And they do. It's just, it's gonna take some, like, some getting used to, some adjusting. The other thing is that this one comes up pretty high right here, so I don't have to worry about underarm spillage. Now, it's not like obnoxiously, like, high or tight, but it is, like, I mean, it's tight compared to any other Buff Bunny bra I've ever worn. This is tight right here. So another reason why I said maybe sizing up is the way to go with this one. And honestly, I feel like you need to size up. Well, not you need to, but comfortably for most of these rib pieces, I would suggest sizing up, and you'll see that as I go through all of the other pieces. One thing I noticed is that on the PDF, they said that this comes with no padding, but mine definitely has padding. There's padding in there. And I know for a fact when we shot for some of the campaign videos, that the one that I wore then also had padding. So I don't know if that's a typo on the PDF or not, but so far the two that I've worn have had padding. Okay. I was gonna tell you, it's a long line, so that's cute. And I don't know, I mean, I like it. I wish I had sized up. Okay, let's do a 360. So I'm gonna put my hair to the back so you can see. One shoulder here. This is tight, I already told you that. Other side, put my hair to the side. Again, this is tight right here, but I don't feel it slutty. Like, it stays pretty put. It's just, I guess, I don't, yeah. And then here's the back. Okay, one shoulder, top seam. It feels fine all through, like, here. It doesn't really feel tight until we get here. That's when I really feel it. But otherwise, the back feels fine. And then the one shoulder strap side, like I said, it comes up pretty high. And it kind of does dig in a little bit. But I think this digging in can be resolved just by sizing up. Next up, I have the Revolution in the color Stardust. So normally I can wear large and extra large Revos. I like both fits. I like large because it just kind of makes me feel a little bit more like put together. But I do like extra large also because it just kind of feels like more free. You know what I mean? It's just, it's comfy. It's a comfy, not oversized, but it's like a comfy, like, light feel. So I'm okay with either one, large, extra large. It really just depends on the day and how I want to, like, feel when I'm at the gym. Do I want to be held in, or do I just want to feel like loosey-goosey and comfy, you know? But this time, this one is an extra large, and I actually didn't ask for this bra. I wanted the Revolution halter, but they sent me the normal Revolution, and I'm not complaining because I love Revolution anyway. I'm still gonna try to get my hands on that Revel halter. But that being said, I am wearing extra large Stardust. It's what we love about Revolution. It's comfy, it's cozy. I love the color. I do want to show you. So I have the Foxy bra here from 70. So this is coming back, but I didn't get this one with this collection. I got it with 70s, okay? But it's also Stardust, so I kind of wanted to put them up side by side so you can see the color. Because I know sometimes when colors come back, you guys have questions like, is it still the same color? To me, they are. If there's any slight difference in color, it's probably just from me washing it, but I think it's the exact same shade. So just FYI, in case you were wondering, they're the same shade. Now, if you're worried about see-throughness, you don't have to worry about it because Revos do come padded. I actually took the padding out of mine, and even then with the padding out, you can't see anything. It's very, like, booby-proof, I guess we could say. It's not squat-proof, it's booby-proof. You can't really see anything. And that's even me with me sizing up and me taking the padding out. So you don't have to worry about showing anything that you don't want to. So just so that we can kind of go over the extra large fit, as you can see, it still fits me nice. It still hugs me. It's just not as like compressive as my larges, which is like, I would do that if I'm doing like something a little bit more higher intensity, or if I know like I'm going to be moving my upper body a lot. Like for example, like when I deadlift, right? When I deadlift, I'm constantly bending over, pulling, things like that. So I prefer to wear my large ones then, just because I feel like I feel more put together. But if I'm doing like upper body, it doesn't matter to me. But so this one in comparison, I mean, they both fit me pretty great. Here's the back, super cute. We love her. She's adorbs. So, revolution. Okay, here I have the Naked sports bra, and I got mine in the color mocha, and I did size up to extra large. So, this bra is a performance fabric. It's not Elysium, I double checked, it's not. But it's pretty similar to Elysium as far as like the feel. I don't feel like it's as like compressive and tight as like Elysium products are. It is still like very good, like medium to high support, but not quite Elysium. Now, this bra does scoop in right here on like the front. And normally I don't like bras like this because I feel like they accentuate like this part of like fat and skin that I have here. But I feel like this one doesn't do it as much as other bras. And I actually really like it. And because it's not tight, like it doesn't dig in at all. It just lays nicely on top of my skin. It's not quite a long line, but it does come pretty low. And again, because I did size up to extra large, it doesn't dig in. So it just kind of like lays nicely on top. And so like my under boobs, like right here, my boobs like stop right here. So they literally come and they cradle them like right under. So they don't feel like they're going to pop out or anything. And again, it doesn't dig in. Now it does have this mesh detailing that goes across. Now it's like multiple layers of mesh. There's not like a solid backing behind it, because if I put my fingers like inside my bra, you can see they're like the shiny reflection of my nails. So I just did want to point that out. Now it is strategically like almost like in the center right here, so I'm not concerned of like anything showing or anything being visible. The way it lays, I think you'll be fine. I don't even think that you can see like the silhouette of like my boobs, so I think you're totally fine. Let me show you the back. So the back is more like racer back, and again, you see how like it just kind of lays nice and flatly. Again, I did size up to extra large, so if you want yours to fit like this, or if you're in between sizes, I totally recommend sizing up. But yeah, it just like, it fits so nicely. It's so stretchy. Do you see how much stretch I have? Yeah, I don't feel like it's tight at all. Now, I do have a short torso, so my bra does connect to the seam of my leggings, but if that is, you know, not your anatomy, then don't worry about it. I will say that when I saw this bra, I thought it was cute, but it really wasn't something that I was like, oh my god, I must have it, it's so pretty. But once I like put it on, I fell in love with it. So I'm so glad I got it. It does have padding. Yeah, it does have padding, removable padding like always. And yeah, I'm really glad I got this. And honestly, I kind of want another color now, because I love the way it feels. It feels so good. Next, I have the Twist bra. And I did size up to extra large. And this bra, I love it. I love the design. I love the twist. I love that it's Nubri, but it's not big titty committee friendly. It's just not. In fact, in the PDF, it literally says recommended for smaller chest sizes. I have a double D cup, and it barely covers what I need it to cover. Why did I size up? So what I have found between the large and the extra large is that there is not a lot of fabric right here. And one of two things was happening with the large. So if I pulled it down to cover my boob, then my nippies would come out to play. And if I pulled it up to cover my nippies, then my under boob would come out to play. It was just like there was no way around it. So I chose to size up to extra large. Now with the extra large, I do get more coverage, but the support is just, it's not there. This is totally more like a lounge bra. Yeah, like lounge at home. I might even like wear it out, like dress it up, you know, with like a cute jacket or yeah, like a blazer or something cute, and then some like nice pants. I think I would wear it like that, just casual lifestyle lounge. Definitely not for any physical activity at the gym. It's just not even for weightlifting, honestly. Like I'm thinking like if I were to do it like back, right? It's gonna require me to raise my arms, and even if I'm doing squats, like it's like I have to, you know, grip the bar, and it just makes things move around. So again, totally recommend for more smaller chest sizes, not so much for the larger sizes. Regardless though, it's going to be more of a light support, low, minimal activity type of bra, but it's so pretty. So let's talk about sizing up though, because when I tried the bra on the very first time, I immediately knew that I was gonna have to size up. I was like, it's not covering anything. In fact, it actually feels a little bit tight right here. I'm gonna have to size up. So I called my friend Amy Jo, and I was like, Amy, if you get the twist bra, I recommend that you size up. And she said, got it. So she sized up on her bra, but when she got it, it didn't work for her. The thing that happened with Amy's is that she has a smaller cup size. So what was happening is that when she would bend over, she would get some gappy, like right here. And then in the back, like the back of the straps. So we realized, just her and I within our exchange, that like if you're a bigger cup, yes, size up, but if you are in the smaller cup size, then you can probably stay with your normal size. There's no need to size up because then you'll have the same gapping that she did. And I'm sure she'll post it on her Instagram or her videos somewhere so you can see what I mean. But yeah, bigger cup size, size up. Smaller cup size, stay true to size. And just be aware that it's very light support. Let me turn around. The back is very simple. It's just a little scoop back with the straps. Nothing like crazy going on. I do like the simplicity of it. And again, it doesn't dig in. Like to me, it doesn't feel like it digs in. It feels really nice. As a member of the BTC, if I had the chance to redesign this bra to make it more inclusive and bigger boob friendly, there are two things that I would do. two things that I would do to improve this bra for bigger chested girls. One is I would expand the amount of fabric that is right here in the cup sizes. I feel like if it came down a little bit more and maybe just a smidge higher up, just a little bit more coverage on both ends, right? Still keep the twist. The twist is still gonna be there, but just offer a little bit more coverage to just kind of keep things a little bit more, I don't even want to say modest, but just more covered up and more comfortable. The other thing that I would do is I would make the back a little bit more flat, kind of like with the naked bra. Do you see how like the naked bra is more like flat and raised your back? I think I would do the same thing, because I think you could still have like this kind of back, and then in the front it comes in and it twists. So those are the two changes that I would make to this bra, and I don't know, I hope that maybe in the future they reinvent it, you know, redo it a little bit, because it is so pretty, and I've been wanting a twist bra for quite a while now. So when I saw that Buff Bunny was coming out with their own twist bra, I was so excited. The first time I saw it actually was in LA. Kara wore it. They brought a sample out to LA, and Kara got to wear it, and I was just like, and it looked so good on her. But we also gotta keep in mind that Kara has a smaller cup size compared to me. So on her, it looked amazing. And once I put it on my double D's, it wasn't the same. But it's a cute bra. Just be aware. Next, I have the Foxy bra. Now, full disclaimer, okay? This is my Foxy bra from 70s Collection. I actually didn't get a Foxy bra this time around in my PR box. But they said that there have been no changes from the previous release to this release. So if you got one the last time, it should fit the same this time. The dimensions should be the same, fabric, everything should be exactly the same. So just wanted to throw that disclaimer out there. But Foxy Bra, Color Stardust, and I am wearing a size large, and I love the way this feels on me. I don't know if I mentioned it whenever I did my 70s review, but this bra was a little tricky for me to fall in love with because the very first time I tried it, I didn't like it. In fact, what happened is I felt like this part would slide down and then I would like get a lot of like excess skin right here, and then I would constantly have to be like pulling it up during my workouts. And at first I did not like it, but I found the trick to making it work. So the back is actually quite adjustable. As you can see, the straps right there are adjustable. So what I found for me that works is I actually have to like bring up the little clasp, make it higher, and then these, the ones that come across, sit up higher, which makes the overall bra come up higher. I hope that makes sense. So if you have one from before and you didn't really quite like it, I totally recommend that you go play around with the straps and just kind of find your best fit, because since it's adjustable, you can probably make it work just like I made mine work. So I adjusted all of mine. I have this, the Stardust one, I have the black one, and I have the blue one, like the Jean Genie blue one. All of them from 70s, and so I adjusted all the straps to come up high, and now I love this bra. I love working out in it. It just feels so good. It's got such good support because it has like all this coverage right here, and it comes up high, and then it's long line, so we got the coverage at the bottom. I've been wearing mine actually quite often, and the other day I wore my black one, and I got two compliments at the gym, like, oh my god, I love your sports bra. And then on my way home from the gym, I went to Target, and then I got two more compliments. Just the random girls would come up to me like, oh my god, I love your bra, or oh my god, I love your outfit. So if you want to get compliments, this is one of those bras that will get you compliments. Next up, I have the ribbed tank, and this is going to be one of my top picks for this collection. Right off the bat, I can tell you that it is a softer, stretchier version of Material Girl. It does not feel like the ribbed seamless stuff. This one feels different. This one is like stretchier, it's softer, the seams don't dig in anywhere, they just lay perfectly flat on me. It does have a liner inside, so I'm gonna raise my shirt. It does have a liner right here, and even the liner does not like dig in. I know like with some of the previous ribbed tanks that have like the liners inside, the liners can kind of like dig in, which makes them like, you know, like kind of looks like bulging on the sides like when you're wearing it. This one does not dig in at all. It is perfect. Now, it does not have padding. I'm wearing padding, but the tank itself does not come with padding. It only comes with that liner. So what I did is I took the padding out of my Revolution, because I don't wear the padding in my Revolution. So I took that padding out because it's the same color, and then I just put it under this one. So the padding is actually just laying between my skin and the liner, and the liner kind of does a really good job at keeping it in place. I don't really have to like fuss with it. It just kind of stays, and I don't really think that you can, I mean, you probably can tell a little bit that I have the padding, but because it's not like tight, it doesn't stand out. I hope that is totally making sense. But yeah, it's so comfy, so cozy. None of these seams dig in. None of these seams are tight. They're all so stretchy and soft, and I just love the look, the effortless cute look of this tank in all of the colors that I've seen. I mean, I've seen all the other girls try on theirs, and it's just like such a cute tank. Perfect for the gym, but also perfect for lifestyle, perfect for lounging, perfect for dressing, like, you know, some cute jeans or some denim shorts. It's just so cute. You can even like wear it like on top of a bathing suit, like for a beach day. I can't say enough about this ribbed tank. I absolutely love it. The back itself is also pretty simple, as you can see. The liner is still there, but do you see how it doesn't like dig in? It just kind of lays perfectly on my back. And then when I pull the shirt down, again, no like excess bulging, no like tightness. It's just so comfortable. This is by far my favorite ribbed crop tank that they've released. This is the Go With The Flow cropped tee. It is super lightweight, so soft. It is very sheer. It's a very see-through top, so no matter what you wear underneath, you're gonna be able to see it. Okay, as you can see, I'm wearing my Revolution under it, but I think it looks super, super cute. Now, I did size up. I can wear large. Large is fine. But I sized up to extra large because I kind of like the more flowy, boxy look of the large, extra large. The large did it too. It's supposed to be a relaxed fit. So the large did it too. But I feel like the extra large just kind of looked better if I wanted it to be more like flowy, relaxed, loungy. So yeah. And then the sleeves are not tight at all. They're very soft and they just kind of like fall perfectly. It is a cropped length, but I feel like it still comes over like my waistband. So my belly button, actually it comes like right where my belly button, the bottom of my belly button is, that's where this shirt kind of lays. And so since my leggings cover my belly button anyway, then you know, there's like no skin showing. Obviously it'll depend on like what bra I wear underneath, but overall I just like how this looks. The back is a crisscross open back, and I'll turn around in just a minute, but you can also wear this shirt backwards, and I'll show you that too. So let's look at it like this. So if you wear the flat in the front, this is what it looks like with the crisscross on the back. So this is what I mean, like it crisscrosses right here. And then it has this, where is it? I can't, it's hard for me to feel. So it has this little strap right here that kind of just keeps the tank in place. That way you can keep the V shape, the cross shape of the, like the overlap of the fabric. And then it also just keeps your tee like nice centered on your shoulders and not like falling off. So I really, really like it. It looks super, super cute. Now, let's turn the shirt around so you can see what it looks like. Ta-da! So as you can see, you can wear the crisscross in the front. The trick is that little strap that comes across is actually behind my neck. And I'll turn around and show you. But so if you wear it like this, it looks like a V-neck that overlaps in the front and so cute. Now, it does fit shorter if you wear it this way around. So this time like my belly button's up here, down here, and now I have like this much of, you know, where this, where the, like my belly button is and then where the shirt ends. So if you wear it this way, it will be shorter because you have to put that strap behind you. But either way, it's still so cute and you can still like do like a little peekaboo of your sports bra. Let me turn around so you can see the back. Okay, so here's the back. And so here's what I mean, like that strap is still gonna go behind you. And if you put, you know, your hair over it, you can't tell. It's just like a nice cropped flowy tee, perfect to throw on top of your sports bra or just like in general, it's a cute little tee. Next, I have the ribbed crop. It is long sleeve. And I honestly think that sizing is just going to depend on your personal preference. Now, I do want to point out that this ribbed fabric is not the same as the ribbed zip-up jacket. This one, completely different fabrics, okay? The one that I'm wearing right now is very like thin, it's very light. This one is thicker, more compressive, completely different type of ribbed fabric. So I will get to this one in just a minute. Let's talk about this one first. Okay, sizing. I have found that in the past, with all of the Buff Bunny long sleeve crops, I can wear large and it's fine, but I think I prefer extra large. Because what happens is it ends up being tight right here. Like the arms tend to be okay. The length tends to be okay. It's just right here, kind of like the top part of my like breast, my chest. That's usually where I find the tightness. So that is why I chose to size up this time. I have other long sleeve crops from like past launches that are large and they fit me. Like I said, they fit me fine. It's just, then you get that like line right here because you know it fits tight around your chest. And so I figured if I sized up, I could kind of eliminate that. And it doesn't really affect how the rest of the crop fits. It still fits perfect. The other thing that I love about sizing up is that you can't see my bra. So with the large, the crop ends where my bra ends, so they're like pretty much like the same, but because I sized up, I get a little bit more length and it actually covers my sports bra. And I'm wearing a Revo, which is a long line. So that tells you, like, my sizing up covers the Revo and I can raise my arms and it still keeps it nice and covered. So I do prefer a sizer up because of my chest. Because of my chest size. If you don't have a bigger chest, you could probably do your normal size, unless you want it to feel a bit more loose or you want a little bit more length, then totally size up. But for me, sizing up is the way to go. Now, it is a long sleeve. There's no thumb holes. There's nothing like fussy about this crop. It's literally just a ribbed long sleeve top with a scoop neck. The back is exactly the same. Nothing crazy going on back here. It's very soft and light and it's cute. Now, right now I'm in the air conditioning and this is nice and comfy, but outside of Houston right now it's like 97 degrees. So I don't know how much use I'm gonna be getting out of this top right now. I mean, I could probably wear it at night or like go to the movies and things like that. But I think I'm gonna get more use out of it once the temperatures drop, like around fall, winter. And the fact that it's a neutral color means you can wear it year round. So even if you're like, I can't wear that right now, it's too hot, but you know in your mind that you would like to have it for the future, I totally recommend that you get it. Next is the ribbed seamless zip up jacket. Okay, like I said before, this is not the same fabric as the crop, the ribbed crop. This one's different. Okay, this one is more like spandexy. It does have spandex in it. It's also thicker and it's also more compressive. Now, I did find that like this part right here, where it has the larger ribbing, it's very light and stretchy. And then the parts where it has like the thinner ribbing, it's a little bit more like, it's still stretchy, but not as stretchy. It's thicker, okay? Now, I did size up in this one as well. I did get an extra large for the same reason, because right here, otherwise it would have felt tight like at the top of my chest and my underarms. So sizing up prevents that. Now, because I did size up, now I get extra like fabric on the sleeves. So I just kind of like tried to like distribute it like up here and my wrist. So it doesn't look bad. It's just something to keep in mind. And then this one does have thumb holes unlike the other one. It is a functional quarter zip. I don't never wear zips like this. Never. But I mean, if you have the option, or if you live somewhere cold, probably because I don't live somewhere cold for like me to have the need to like bundle up like that. But you know, if you live in an area where, you know, you start getting snow in September, then this might come in handy. Another reason why you might want to keep in mind sizing up is depending on what you want to wear underneath. So with mine, I'm just wearing my Revo, but if you like know that you're probably going to be wearing like something thicker, or you know, like a thicker cropped shirt underneath, then you might consider sizing up just so you have the extra space for whatever you're going to wear under. But if you're just gonna wear a sports bra underneath, then you should be totally fine. The back is very simple and plain, still, like I showed you, plenty of stretch. Just like with the cropped shirt, I probably won't be getting a lot of use of this one right now during summertime. But come fall, come winter, I know that I'm going to be using the heck out of it. Another one of my top picks for this collection, the exposed mesh jacket. Now, this is very reminiscent of the Escandala pullover, if you remember that one. It's also mesh. Now, obviously, it's way different from the Escandala. The Escandala was literally a pullover, and then it had pockets, and it had a drawstring to like cinch in the waist, and it had a hood. This one is different. This is a jacket. So this one has a zipper for sure. You can still zip it. And the first time I tried this one on was also in LA. And I tried on both the large and the extra large. They both fit fine. The only thing that I wanted the extra large, because I wanted it to be a little bit more like flowy and like loose down here. Just, I don't know, it felt and it looked nicer in my opinion, but I could totally wear both. Neither one of them, like the large, did not fit tight. It wasn't tight on my arms, it wasn't tight on my chest or anything. I just preferred the extra large. But, so you can totally zip this one up. You know, do the half zip situation or do the totally unzip situation. And then this one also has pockets, but they're not very functional. So I'm gonna show you, they're actually right here on the sides. And so they're like, they're there, but if you put your hands in there, it looks like you're grabbing your boob. And then can you imagine if I was doing both, it'd be like walking around grabbing my boobs. So they're not very functional. You could totally put like a key in here and, you know, it'll sit right here in the front, like a key, a chapstick, something little like that. But I wouldn't be stuffing it. I wouldn't be stuffing these pockets with stuff, because then you'd be all like wulky up here. But it's great to have the option. Now, this jacket does not have thumb holes, but like I said, I signed up, so the sleeves are a little bit longer and bigger on me, but I don't care. I kind of like that. I like the longer, bigger look, on my opinion, but just know that there's no thumb holes, so we've got the mesh, but then we have the solid fabric right at the sleeves. No hood, but this is what it looks like in the back, and so right now I'm wearing it unzipped. Let me zip it up for you so you can see what it looks like when it is zipped. All right, so now it's zipped, and you can see that it's still like not digging in. I still have plenty of room all up in here, and it doesn't look bad at all. I feel like this is a very nice, like, neutral color, and I don't have any jackets that are like this color. They're always like black or white. So I was like, you know what? Let me get this color because I think it'll be perfect. And I was not wrong. I love it. This is another top pick for me. Okay, let's move on to the shorts, and I'm gonna start with the ribbed seamless shorts. So this short is nothing like the Material Girl shorts. If you remember, they released some, I believe they were 4-inch ribbed, like Material Girl ribbed shorts with the Off the Grid collection. I did review those, but those would definitely slide on me. They were very stretchy, very soft. Those shorts were great for lounging, but they, I guess, wanted to make like a more performancey one. So then in comes the ribbed seamless short. So this is the short right here. I have a lot of thoughts about this short, and I was really hopeful for this short, but I don't hate it. It's just, I wish it fit me better. First of all, I had to size up, not once, twice. So these are actually a 2XL. These are 2X. I got the extra large, because you know I always get extra large shorts. So I got the extra large, and it just was not working for me, as you can see right here. They were way too tight. They were digging into my thighs, and then they just create this funny looking like bulges, like where the seams were. It just was not working. So I asked if I could get exchange for an extra extra large instead, and so that's what we did. So this is the extra extra large, and I will say these fit so much better. So much better than that other pair. And I don't mind like the sizing up. To me, sizing is just, it's just a company's way to like measure their clothing, you know, because I'm definitely, I can be medium in some, and I apparently am extra, extra large in these. So it just, that doesn't bother me. What I have found though is that these shorts are, they don't, just don't work for my thighs, okay? They have this scrunch right here, and it makes the booty look so freaking good. But then the seam, so I'm gonna pull it up close so you can see. So it's like this around the booty, and then we have this like ribbed seam along the bottom. So we've got like the nice little contour for the booty, but then we have the ribbing right here. This ribbing is tight compared to like the cheek part, which I get it, because this is supposed to like, you know, cradle your butt cheek and make it look good, and then this is supposed to, you know, like come in tight, but it's a little too tight on my thighs. I think my thighs are just too big for these particular shorts, because they do still dig in, not a lot, but I want you to see something, okay? Because I don't want you to like be turned off by these shorts. These shorts are still stretchy. They're still stretchy. Like, look, this is the leg, literally. So here's the short, I'm turning it upside down, here's the leg. super stretchy. They're still stretchy. So I don't want you to like think, oh my God, those like are so like tough. They're not. They're actually quite stretchy. They just, I guess I have really big thighs and I like stretch them to capacity and then they really won't go beyond that. So they actually don't feel bad like when I'm up and moving around or anything like that. I can sit comfortably, I can walk comfortably. It's when I start raising my legs, like whenever, like if I do like a march or a run or anything like that, which I'm not really running, but like you know what I mean? Like if I raise my leg, that's when it like starts to roll up. And yeah, other than that, except for this, they are perfect. I love the waistband. It's like, the compression is there. It just hugs my waist so nicely. I love the booty scrunch in the back. I just love how it accentuates everything. I like how it makes me look so freaking snatched. It's just this. So if you have powerful thighs like me, I recommend that you definitely size up. But then also just keep in mind, depending on how big your thighs are, that it might fit you a little tight too. I will say though, again, my extra, extra large are a dream compared to my extra large, because extra large is not working. But yeah, this waistband, it's stretchy too. Here, I'm gonna show you. These are stretchy. I don't know why they wouldn't fit my body the way I wanted them to fit me. But they're super stretchy. And it's like, it's perfect. It hugs everything so nice and tight. I'm gonna keep wearing them. I'm kind of hopeful that the more I wear them, the more that the seam around my thighs is going to, I guess, get stretched out and just kind of like get more comfortable. I'm also like trying to lose weight right now. Between the last launch and this launch, I've lost 10 pounds. So I'm kind of hoping that the more I drop down in weight, the more comfortable they will also feel on my thighs. It's also possible that they just feel this way because of all the extra loose skin I have in my inner thighs, just from weight loss in general. So I don't know, maybe that extra skin right there is what makes these like extra tight and what makes them roll. Definitely check out the reviews from some of the other girls just to like confirm, but this is my personal experience with these shorts. Do I hate them? No. Do I love them? Almost. Would I buy them again? I think I would. I know that's gonna sound a little like weird, but I think I would, because I do generally like the way that they're supposed to like fit your body, and I can see it. I can see how like it's almost there on me. So yeah. Now I will like to point out these are very sheer. This booty part right here, it's sheer, okay? It's sheer. You're gonna see everything. So these are definitely going to be more of a like nude underwear or no underwear type of situation. And then if you wear no underwear, you will be able to see your booty cheeks. So if you have like tattoos or anything back there, you will be able to see them through this fabric. I'm not gonna sit here and lie to you, they will. And I mean, you'll see the pictures video right here, so you can see that for yourself. Do I mind? Not really, I mean, you know, it is what it is. It's just skin. But I know, again, not everyone is there comfort level wise. So just wanted to make sure that you're aware. They're sheer in the black, but I double checked with Kara because Kara got one of the brown colors. And she didn't get the shorts. She got the leggings. But even in the leggings, they are still sheer. So I don't think it really matters what color you get. They're going to be sheer in the booty. But yep. Seamless ribbed short. Next up is the contour pocket short, and I did get these in extra large and they fit perfect. They fit just like my 6-inch shorts. They're perfect on the waistband, perfect on my thighs, perfect everywhere in the booty. They're perfection. Now these are Nuri fabric. These are 4-inch, but they have pockets. I love the V-shaped seam in the back, very similar to like Rosa shorts. And then in the front, we've got the little like contouring lines right here, and then it goes deep in. And then of course we have the pockets. Now, because these are 4-inch shorts, the pockets are not very big. They're big enough that like I can put my hand in here. See, like they're big enough. But depending on how big your cell phone is, they may or may not fit. Let me put my cell phone in here real quick. Okay, so if I put my cell phone in there, it fits. Okay, I mean obviously like the little wristband part doesn't fit, but I can fit my phone in there. And it does quite stretch. The one thing that I will point out though is that some of the other girls, when I've asked them like how theirs fit, they said that they felt like the pocket made their hips look wider. I have wide hips to begin with anyway, so I didn't feel that way, me personally, because like I said, I have wide hips anyway. And no matter what I wear, I'm gonna look like I have wide hips. But some of the other girls who don't have as wide hips as I do mentioned that they felt like the pockets made their hips look wider. So something to keep in mind. If you want to have that hourglass wide hip look, you're gonna love these. But if you're trying to avoid that, then I don't know how you're gonna feel about it. So I did want to point that out. I got mine in the color Cocoa, and this color is pretty decent at being squat proof. I think you really have to be like intentionally looking to where my underwear is to be able to see the underwear. Compared to some of these other colors, this color is pretty decent. I'm gonna say that, and I love it. I also really love how this cocoa color complements my skin tone. I'm not gonna lie, I think I'm blessed, because I think every single one of these colors looks really good against my skin tone. I don't feel like any of them make me look naked. I know that's a concern for some of us, like neutrals, I'm gonna look naked. I don't think that any of them make me look naked. If anything, maybe like the Stardust bottoms might make me look a little bit naked, because I am quite pale, like my legs are quite pale. So but yeah, I don't know, I love this color and I'm so excited I got it. And contour pocket short. Next, I have the 6-inch Legacy short. What can I say? Like, 6-inch shorts are just pure perfection. They're not too long, where like they make my short legs look shorter. They're not too short to where they like ride up and my booty cheeks are falling out everywhere. They are just perfect. I did get extra large. I get extra large in all my shorts. And they're just perfect. They're perfect. I love them in courtside. I love them in cake. I love them in, what else? What was the last one that came out? Dream House. I love them in naked. I love them so freaking much. And honestly, if I could get all of my 4-inch legacies and magically turn them all into 6-inch, I would be happy. I would be a happy girl, because 6-inch is perfect. It does not ride up. It doesn't dig in. It just makes me feel so comfortable. And I love wearing my 6-inches to the gym. The only sad part is that I only have one pair, because I need every single color of these. So I guess we can say this is another Dedit top pick, because they're just perfection. But I mean, I don't know what else I can do. Like, they got the tri-seam in the back. They're perfection. They're perfect. No complaints, no notes. Moving on to leggings. Here are the Legacy leggings. Now, Legacy leggings are a Buff Bunny staple. They're pretty much in like every launch, every other launch. I've reviewed them hundreds of times. Well, not literally hundreds, because I haven't been around that long, but I reviewed them like almost every single launch that they've come out. So I'm not gonna go too much into detail. If you're new to Buff Bunny and you wanna know about Legacy leggings, just, you can go watch any of my other reviews where I go a little bit more in depth. Just know that they're newbie fabric, they're double brushed, they're super soft, they're body contouring, they have this lovely tri-seam on the back of the waistband with a little deep V to just kind of make your booty look so good. What I'm gonna do instead of reviewing the Legacy legging itself, I'm gonna review this color. Okay,
This is the color Stardust. I love this color. So I got the Stardust, the flared leggings whenever, what was the launch that they had the flared leggings? Cake had flared leggings. And I got the Stardust flare leggings. And I love the way the flared leggings looked on me. That was kind of like my like test. So like, do I like this color on me? And I do. I generally like the color on me. I like the flare look. And the flare ones have the same like tri-seam on the back, like legacy leggings. So when this launch came around, I was like, all right, it's time to go for the legacies. Okay. Do I love the legacies? Yes. I still love the color. I still love the way it fits me. The only thing is that I find like legacies kind of accentuate the sheerness. I feel like, no, Milo's about to start barking. Hold please. As I was saying, I feel like the legacies kind of seem just a smidge more sheer. It could totally be just be my imagination, but just FYI, yes, they are sheer. So for these, I totally recommend nude undies or just no undies if you're okay going commando, because you will be able to see it as evident by the video here on the screen. I did get mine enlarged, which is my usual Nubri size. They fit fine, but the first time I put them on, I kind of had to wiggle into them. They're not as tight as, like, I know there have been other colors that are like legacy and then you put them on and they're like really tight. These weren't like that. They weren't like Scarlet Rosa tight by any means, but I did have to wiggle into them the first time just to kind of like break them in, I guess. But then after that first time, I was able to put them on just fine. So just heads up, because if you get them and the first time you put them on, you're like, oh my God, they're so tight or whatever. They kind of, I don't want to say they stretch out, but they kind of like break in and become like more like your size, your shape. So just FYI, I'm happy with my large. I found that if I size up a Nubri to extra large, they're easy to put on, obviously, yes, but then I end up having a lot of like excess fabric, like in the front, like around my crotch or at my ankles, just like an overabundance of fabric. So I still would rather stick to large in Nubri. My personal preference, I like how they fit. I like how they look on me. So yeah, I always say like Nubri stuff is more true to size. I know a lot of girls, I don't know if they still do it, but I know for a while, a lot of girls were sizing down in Nubri because they just prefer that tighter look too. So I guess if we're saying I'm in between sizes, large and extra large, and I prefer large, then I guess technically I am sizing down. But yeah, I like them. Yeah, legacy leggings. Next, I have the Contour Pocket Legging. So this legging is very similar to the Rosa Pocket legging. The biggest difference that I see between this one and Rosa Pocket is that this one just has extra seams. So it's got like extra seams right here, like in the waistband. Comes in like a little bit lower. The back, it's got these little contour waistlines right here. So I guess that's why it's called the Contour Pocket legging, because those little seams kind of make it kind of look like it's coming in. Almost like a corset legging, but not really. Like, it does not fit like the corset legging, I'll be very honest. So that's really the biggest difference, because other than that, they're very similar to Rosa's. They have pocket, which is pretty much the same dimensions. They're Nubri fabric. They come up about the same, like literally the same on like the waistband, same inseam, everything. So Rosa Pocket, Contour Pocket, very similar except for the seams. So if you want the seams to kind of like accentuate more of like a contour, then I would say go with the Contour Pocket legging. If you don't like seams, then I would say go with the Rosa Pocket legging. Or, you know, get one of each, whatever tickles your pickle. But I like this legging. I did find it to be very stretchy too. Do you see? Like, such a stretchy. This is stretchier than my Stardust color, my Stardust Legacy. Okay, these are both Nubri. These are both Nubri. This is Legacy, this is Contour Pocket. Large. The only difference is that this is Stardust and this is Brady Brown. Stardust is a little bit like I said, not as stretchy or just, not that it's not as stretchy, it's just, it was a little stiffer to put on the first time. This one went on like butter. So just you'll be fine with this color, with this one. I don't know if it's the design or the color itself, because I only have it in this color, but Brady Brown, true to size, definitely love it. Love the pockets. This one is actually pretty good at being squat proof, as you'll see from the videos here on the screen. I think it's the color that makes it squat proof. As far as compression, I would say it's more like light to medium compression, but it's still decent for the gym. I've already worked out in these. Actually, I've worked out in most of these pieces. I think the only thing I have not worked out in is the booty pant and the ribbed, the seamless legging. And I'll talk about those when I get to them. But I've already worked out in these, and they held up really well at the gym. So I love these. I love these as much as the Rosa Pocket. And y'all know I love my Rosa Pockets. I think for me personally, I prefer no seams. So I like the Rosa Pocket maybe just a teeny tiny more, but that's just a personal preference for me because I like less seams. This one has more seams, so and then like the seam, like in the front, I hope you can see it, it's like kind of comes like this, like a scoop around the front of the leg, and then on the back of the leg again it's that little scoop right there. So again, it's just really personal preference if you like seams or no seams. If you like all the extra seams to give you that contoured look, contour. If you don't want all those extra seams, then just go with the Rosa Pocket. I don't know. I think Contour Pocket comes in more colors, and I feel like Rosa Pocket only comes in like 2 or 3, whereas this one comes in 5. So also another thing to keep in mind, but Contour Pocket legging, I love and I approve. Next up, I have the Queen Bee legging. I got mine in the color mocha, so it matches my naked bra. It matches especially because we've got the mesh detailing that the naked bra also has. So it's like the naked little mesh detail right here. It's kind of, I'm trying to look, make sure I show it to you. So this legging is really cute. It's been a long time since we've had this legging. Years, three plus years probably. And to be honest, I didn't have it the original time, so I couldn't tell you if they fit like the last ones because I don't have those, so I've got no idea to be able to compare. What I can do is review this fit, this style. So when I read the description, I knew that it wasn't Nubry, and usually when leggings are not Nubry, I like to size up just because I feel like they might fit a little bit better, especially if they're like slick performance-y fabric. So I did size up to extra large and I regret it. I regret it because first of all, these leggings are very stretchy. Do you see? They're super stretchy. And I feel because I sized up, and I will show you right here in the screen, I feel like I have so much extra fabric. I feel like I have extra fabric kind of like in the, like, you know, like right there beside my hips, beside my pubic bone area. I feel like I have extra fabric there. I feel like it also bunches in my knees. It's just too much fabric. And it doesn't, although it doesn't slide, it doesn't roll, it doesn't slide, but it just doesn't feel like compressive. So I regret sizing up. I should have stuck to large. I should have known. I mean, you know, half the time I size up, and then I regret it. So yeah, I would say these are true to size. Don't size up unless you don't like the tight feeling, unless you don't want to, you know, feel like held in. If you want to be more like loose, I won't say loose, more relaxed, I don't know what the terminology is, then you can size up. But for me, as you can see, it's just the extra large didn't work. I should have stuck to large. I should have sized down to my large. I should have known. Okay. This one, this fabric is just not very cellulite friendly. Like, I feel like most, depending on how much cellulite you have, like, I have a lot. So, most leggings are going to show my cellulite regardless. But I feel like this fabric is not as forgiving as Nubry fabric. I feel like this one kind of accentuates it a little bit more, or maybe it's because they're not tight on me. I don't know. Maybe it's because they're too big for me, and that's why, like, you can see it. Maybe if they were tighter, it kind of would hold everything in better. So yeah, I do feel like you can see my cellulite a lot more with these. Also, the mesh parts right here, there is no solid backing to the mesh, so you will see skin, and if you wear underwear, you will see the underwear. You will see it. Can't hide it, okay? I did try on different kinds of underwear, and not here, but like when I originally got it. And no matter what underwear I wore, you could see it. Like the only one that you couldn't see was like this high rise, like almost like a string thong that I have. But I just don't like working out in those kinds of underwear, so I was like, I'd rather just go commando. So when I did wear these to the gym and for my photo shoot, I just didn't wear underwear with them because it just felt better that way. But if you do wear underwear, you will be able to see it. If you wear nude underwear, you can still see it, okay? So just a heads up. So if that's a deal breaker for you, then maybe stay away from these leggings. The color itself seems to be pretty squat proof. This color that I got, where did I tell you? Mocha, I think I got it. Yeah. Seems to be pretty squat proof for the most part. Don't really see anything. So I like this color. I like this color, how it looks against my skin. It's actually the same color of my ribbed zip jacket. So yeah, another thing that I noticed is that, like, I don't know if you can see it, but in the waistband, it kind of like dips. So it's like up here and then it dips in and then it's straight across. I hope that makes sense. And at first I was like, oh my God, it's gonna fit low rise on my belly. And I'm not a low rise stan. I cannot do low rise, but they don't fit like that at all. They fit like normal high-waisted leggings to me. So don't let that deter you or scare you. Definitely they'll stick with your normal size. Do not make the mistake of sizing up like I did. But other than that, I feel like I like this color, but I have a feeling I probably would have liked them a little bit more in black. But you know, I gotta branch out from always black, because I feel like a third of my baby wardrobe is black. Yeah, like a third of my BB wardrobe is black, and I need to branch out into more colors. So I purposely decided not to get black, but I think I would have probably liked them a little bit more if they were black, just my personal preference. But that doesn't mean I don't like this color. I do like it. Yeah. Next, I have the ribbed booty pants. It's a flared pant. So when I saw this pant and I saw the name, I assumed that it was like booty pant, like butt, like booty butt pant. But once I tried it on, I think I was mistaken. I think they meant booty pant, like boot cut, because of the flare, not because of the booty part, if that makes sense. Because what I was expecting is for this to make my butt look delicious, and it doesn't. It actually doesn't really do much for my butt, and this is not my favorite. It's for my body type, my body shape, and my curves, this doesn't really work for me, which I guess I'm kind of a little sad about it, because when I saw it, I was so excited for it. I was so happy. I was like, oh, give me. And then I got it and I put it on and I didn't like it. I don't like how it looks on me. I don't know. Y'all tell me. So first of all, this ribbing material is super stretchy. Look, super stretchy. I did get extra large, and I'm glad I did. Even though it's super stretchy and it stretches a lot, I am glad I got extra large, and I'm going to show you why right here. The back of the waistband, in my opinion, sits lower compared to the front, and I haven't had any Buff Bunny legging that where when I bend over or squat, you can see my underwear. Like, it's one thing if you can see my underwear because the legging is sheer, you can see it through the material, but it's something completely different for like the back of the waistband to be so low that my underwear pops out the top, if that makes sense. So even just like when I put them on, like I'm used to like putting them on and then, you know, pulling up the waistband, and it totally covers like, you know, my booty humps. These were like barely going over, and this is an extra large, so you know that large would have not fit my back there. It just would not have. So I'm glad I got extra large. The other thing I want to note is that I got the regular length. So this one comes in 32 inch inseam and 34 inch inseam. So 32 is considered short, and 34 is considered regular. There's not like a tall option, it's just short or regular. So I got the regular one, and I'm 5'2", and it looks pretty short on me. For it being the regular length and I'm 5'2", I feel like it should have fit me longer. Because when I wear the regular, like, flared, Foxy, is it Foxy Flare? When I wear the regular flared leggings, they're, like, almost a little too long. So that's why I usually get the short ones. But these, I got the regular ones, and they feel short. Especially once I add shoes on there, I don't know. I feel like I have to wear flat sneakers for this one to work. I can't wear, like, chunky sneakers on this one, because then it's going to be too short and going to look like, you know, what's the term? Like, high waters? So, yeah, just something to keep in mind. So if you're a tall girly, I don't know if you're going to like these. I don't know if they're going to work for you. They might be too short. They might feel too short. So just heads up. Yeah, and then like I said, for the booty, it doesn't really do anything. It has one straight up and down seam on the butt crack, but there's like no contouring to it. It doesn't come into a cute little V. It's just, the seam is just there, and it doesn't do anything for my butt. And so yeah, so that's what made me think that this was not supposed to be booty leg, booty legging. It's supposed to be booty leg boot cut legging. I should have asked. But anyway, I think that if you are on the slimmer side of body composition, you might like these. I mean, they look amazing on Heidi. Have y'all seen Heidi wear these? They look so good on her. And that's what I was hoping they would look like on me. But they don't. So, I don't know. I think if you're, like, slimmer, petite, you'll love these. If you are curvier, maybe taller, maybe not these. Let's talk accessories, because we actually got quite a number of accessories this time around. I'm gonna start with the belt bag. The belt bag design is the same as all of the previous release belt bags. Nothing has changed. The only difference is that, well, the colorways. Oh, see, like, I haven't even taken the plastic. Do y'all, like, take this off? Are y'all gonna, like, get upset if I take it off? I know it, like, now it's prone to scratching because I just took it off. And I'm horrible about that. When I had my marble backpack, I think I didn't take the little plastic things off, the metal branding, for like 2 months. And not because I didn't want to, just because I totally like kept forgetting and missing it. But anyway, squirrel moment. Belt bag. So this is the belt bag. It's very simple. It's just one big pocket. One big pocket. There are no inside pockets, no liners, nothing on the back. This belt bag is cute, but again, if I could redesign the Buff Bunny belt bag, I would add more pockets. I would add more compartments. I would at least, at the very minimum, add a zipper pocket on the inside, or like a mesh pocket back here. I have quite a number of belt bags. I am not a purse girl. I don't really care for purses. The only time I ever really use a purse is if like I'm dressed up and, you know, like if I'm wearing a dress, it looks cuter, like a nice dress. It looks cuter if you wear like a purse versus a belt bag. But honestly, 90% of the time, I'm a belt bag girly. So I'm kind of like a belt bag snob at this point. And I do like the size of this. I do like the colors of it, but I just wish it had more compartments. It needs more compartments. So Buff Bunny Collection, if you're watching this review video, let me redesign it. Let me help you. Because we can make this belt bag so much better. Okay, but anyway, I have extended the, oh, by the way, it's all metal stuff. I have extended it to its capacity, and it does fit like crossbody, like that. And I mean, I'll show you pictures here. It does fit crossbody, so if you like to wear yours over, you should be fine doing that if you extend it all the way, or you can just wear it for like around the waist. I got mine in the color chocolate, but it will also come in hazelnut, which is like that light brown color, and then almond milk, which is like that almost like stardusty white color. But yeah, that's a belt bag. Another accessory we get this time around is socks. So these are crew socks. They're not scrunch socks. With the Kate collection, they were scrunch socks. So like this part was very like wide and like scrunchy, and it like, it was perfect. These are crew socks. So these are much like straighter, narrower. They still have stretch to them, like this is the part where I always double check because I don't like it digging into my ankle. So it does have stretch to it. I wear a size 7.5 shoe. So I got the smaller size of the socks because they do stretch, see? And then I also got them in half crew because they will come in half crew and full crew. And full crew is just too much for me, especially because I have bigger calves. So then those tend to be too tight on me. So the half crew was the way to go for me. They only come in the color Stardust, which is this little cream color. And then they've got the BB branding little logo woven in right there. Super cute. Two sock options. You already know that if there's a scrunchie, I'm gonna get a scrunchie. Oh, but not just one scrunchie. I'm gonna get all the scrunchies, because when I go to the gym, I like to use these scrunchies because they don't crease my hair. Look at all these colors. They're so freaking pretty. I love them. So I got literally every color of the scrunchie and I'm so excited. So the way I like to use these is, I like wearing my hair down. I'm a hair down girly through and through. Even when I go to the gym, I wear my hair down. But there are times when I have to put my hair up. So then I use one of these babies to secure just a very loose pony or a very loose bun at the top of my head, because I am also not a low bun or low pony girl. I can't do it. I'm high all the time. And so I like to use these, and they always they match perfect with my outfits because it's all the Buff Bunny colors. So I'm so excited that these are back. They're newbie fabric. They're oversized. They're super stretchy, and they tend to sell out pretty quickly. Anytime there's a launch with scrunchies, they tend to sell out. So if you have not tried a scrunchie, try at least one just to see if you like them. And if you're a scrunchie stan like me, then be happy because we get a lot of colors. Also launching with this collection are Game Changer backpacks. I asked for one, I wanted one, but they didn't send me one in my PR box. So I don't have one to show you, but they're the exact same from all of the other Game Changer backpacks. Literally exactly the same. The only thing that's different is the colorways. If you've never seen me review a Buff Bunny backpack, go to my last video for Dreamhouse, because I reviewed the Chroma Pink one. So go back to that one. But yeah. We get three color options and they're gorgeous, and that might have to be on my shopping list. I think I really, really want one. Another accessory that I don't have, but it's also launching, is the dad hat. They're the same style as the previous ones. They've got the leather little strap on the back, and I love me a dad hat. I am not a trucker hat girl. I know a lot of you love trucker hats, and I'm happy that you love trucker hats. I am not a trucker hat girl. I feel like they make my head look big and they just look weird on me. So I'm glad that they're dad hats. If you're a trucker hat girly, fingers crossed that they come up with a trucker hat for you in the future and that makes you happy. But me, I'm happy because I get the dad hats. And so, like I said, I didn't get one this time around. I do have three from before. I have the black one, and I have the pink one. And I want to say I have another one. I do have, I have them, and they do get a lot of use, especially right now, summertime. I don't wear hats to the gym a lot often. I don't like having too much stuff on my head. Like, if I already have a ponytail and headphones, I really don't want to add a hat to it. So I usually don't wear my hats to the gym unless I'm just pissed off at the world and I don't want anyone to see me, then I'll wear the hat. So generally what I wear my dad hats for is the beach, a pool day, to go kayaking, the lake. That's the more that kind of recreational stuff, I'll wear my dad hats. And I absolutely love them. So I do plan to buy at least the nutmeg one, the brown one, the light brown one. I do plan to buy that one. That's on my personal shopping list because I do love the dad hats. Another item that I did not receive, but I have tried on and love, is the long sleeve graphic tees. They fit very similar to the Moves tee, if you got the Moves tee. The only difference is that they are long sleeve. So they're meant to be oversized, and they recommend that you size up for that oversized look. So I am wearing extra large in this picture right here, and I love the way the extra large fits me. I like how oversized and boxy it is. And I love how it just kind of covers everything. So Yeah, I love them. They're gonna come in several different colors. I love how the way like moves is still on there, like the moves tee, except it's like move across your torso and then the S for the moves is on your sleeve. I think it's a really cute design. And this is also on my personal shopping list. Next, I have the ribbed seamless leggings. And these are actually fresh off of the UPS truck. I don't know if you can tell, but I'm in a completely different outfit and the lighting is completely different outside right now. I've been waiting on these all day so I could finish the review. So I actually had a pair of these in large and could I squeeze into them? Yes. Should I be squeezing into them? No. They were way too tight. And because I was stretching them out so much to be able to squeeze into them, they became so freaking sheer that you could see everything, like down to like the mole on my butt cheek, the tag inside of the leggings. You could see everything. So I was like, yeah, that's definitely not going to work. So I got the extra large instead, and I'm so glad I did because sizing up made a world of a difference with these. Okay, so this ribbed legging, once again, is not like Material Girl at all, okay? This legging has a lot of different like ribbing sizes. So I'm gonna get really close here so you can see. I hope it shows on the camera, but there's like this ribbing and then there's like a slightly different one right there. And then there's this one right here. So all of these different ribbing effects create like all these different contours to the legging. And then on the back, like you can see the little contour for the butt cheek. And then again, that ribbing that goes under the butt cheek, like at the hamstrings. So it kind of like perks your booty up and it gives it that nice contour, you know, so we get that bubble butt effect. And so I love these leggings. I'm gonna be really honest, when I tried on the large, I was so disappointed. I thought I was gonna not like these leggings anymore. I was like, they don't work for me. But now that I've sized up and I see how they fit me once I sized up, I'm so happy. I'm so happy. There's definitely a difference between large to extra large, but it's not anything like super crazy. They definitely still feel compressive. They definitely still feel supportive. I just did notice a little bit of extra fabric bunching like around my knees, but I can deal with that as long as like my waist and my hips are good and my butt is covered. I am okay with just a tiny bit of fabric at like around my knees. I could easily just have messed with the fabric and distributed it across the rest of my legs or towards my ankles and I would have been fine. This waistband, super stretchy but yet supportive. We love the deep V contour in the back of the booty. I love these leggings. I love these leggings. They are still a little bit sheer. I'm not gonna lie to you, they're still a bit sheer. But nowhere near as sheer as the wrong size that I had. That large was not gonna work. It just wasn't. I mean, I wore them, I squeezed into them, didn't tear them or anything, they were fine, but you could see everything. So if you're between sizes, definitely size up. If you're part of the big booty committee, not the big titty committee, the big booty committee, I suggest you size up too, just so you can get that extra coverage on your booty cheeks, because otherwise they will be very, very sheer. These will come in, I don't want to lie to you, they're only coming in mocha and black, which is the same as the shorts, but yeah, I love them. I'm glad I got black too. I know we just had a whole conversation about me branching out, trying other colors besides black, but I just want it black anyway. I'm glad I got it. Next up is the Ivy bodysuit right here, which is actually what I'm wearing right now. And I'm so excited to have a bodysuit in this collection. The last time we had bodysuits like this was with Bloom. And that was 2 years ago. That was 2 years ago. So we were a long overdue. Or did we have one after that? I might be having a brain fart moment. I know there was one with Newbery Collection. But that was way too short for me. Regardless, so we've got this one. It's the Ivy bodysuit. brand new design. It is a 4-inch inseam, and it's there's a Nubry fabric, but the back, or like the top part, is like the ivy crop, which I also love. I love the ivy crop, so I was excited that they combined that with, let's say, like a 4-inch short and then Nubry fabric and put together, and we got this lovely bodysuit. I know it's 4 inches and a lot of us prefer to have 6, but I'm not mad at the 4. It actually still looks really good. It stays in place pretty well for me. I was so happy about that. And then the straps are actually adjustable. So yeah, on the ivy crop, they're not adjustable. And I know the very first time the straps were like, people were complaining that they were too short, then they changed them, and then people were complaining that they were too long, and then they tried to bring them back, and it's just like, it's been a back and forth with that ivy crop. So the fact that they made them adjustable in this bodysuit is like, perfect, because now everybody can just adjust it to fit your shoulder size, your trap size. The other thing with it being adjustable is that it's a hook and eye clasp, so you can unhook it from right here. Ooh, let me get my hair out of the way. You can unhook it from right here so that you can step into the bodysuit and put it on, because there are no zippers or buttons or anything like that. So you actually have to take the straps off, step into it, and then put the straps back on. Piece of cake. It wasn't like a difficult task to do that. It was really easy. And then the other thing is that since it's adjustable, then you can play around with this. Now, mine doesn't sit on my collarbone. My collarbone is like up here. And for me, it's down here. So to me, it doesn't bother me. But I know in the past when we've had adjustable bras, some of y'all ask if the clasps sit on your collarbone because it like irritates your collarbone. Mine doesn't sit there, so it doesn't irritate me. It doesn't bother me. It's perfectly fine. I guess really it's just gonna be based on like your anatomy, and you're gonna have to put it on and figure out if it works for you or not. I did wanna point out though that since this is unclaspable, is that a word? Since you can unclasp it, this can be like a breastfeeding friendly, that's not the right word. What is it? Nursing friendly bodysuit, because you can totally undo it, pop out your boobie, feed your baby, put it back on, you're good to go. So yeah, I know that's not what its intended purpose is, but it's, you know, like a little extra that you get from it. So if you are a new mama with a baby or a mom-to-be, and that's something that, you know, might be beneficial for you, that's a great thing to keep in mind. The top of the bodysuit does have removable padding. It doesn't have a shelf bra or a liner. It just has the padding in there, which to me, it's fine. It's kind of like the ivy crop that has the padding in there. You can take it out, whatever. I kept mine in. I actually like how supportive it feels. So, yeah. And I'm going to say it, but this is another Dede top pick for this collection.
All right, you guys, and that is it for this collection. Thank you for hanging out with me. And if you have any questions, make sure that you put them in the comments. I'll be coming by periodically to answer as many questions as I can. But once again, make sure that you also follow me on Instagram, where I do have story highlights, and I have been saving all of your questions, and I will be adding color comparisons and everything else leading up until launch. All right, I will see you next time. Bye.